Comparison. You knocked on my door, and without asking who it was, I opened. You started to speak, to entangle your web of lies, and I entertained them. I moved aside and let you in, unknowingly inviting your cousin's jealousy and envy. Hospitable me allowed you to make yourself comfortable, you know, in the spirit of mi casa es tu casa, pero no. I gave you an inch and you took the entire mile, made my heart your home, kicking God off of his rightful throne. Comparison, I embraced you, made you my friend. You became a comforter when I was floating in mediocrity and an anchor around my throat when I was flowing in creativity. You kept me up and you sank me down simultaneously. I hated you for making me feel like I would never be good enough. And I loved you for making me feel that in spite of the above, I was still better than some. You were a broken mirror, reflecting to me the shattered ideals of this world. Comparison, you are not my friend. You are my enemy, who just like the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Steal my peace, kill my joy, and destroy my confidence, my godfidence. Trying to blind me to the truth that I am fearfully and wonderfully made, and that so is everybody else. That we're all here on purpose and for purpose, and that our purposes were never meant to compete, but rather to complete each other. So comparison, get your ish and get out. This house, this temple, this body, this mind, this creativity no longer welcomes you, no longer belongs to you. I am free. I am all that God says about me. I am worthy, redeemed, forgiven, accepted, loved. I am His. And so are you.